პროექტის მიზანია რომ შექმნას ქირურგიული საოპერაციო სიმულატორი, რომელიც თან იქნება თამაში. სიმულატორის ფუნქცია არის განათლების სფეროში ჩართვა აქტიურად და რეალურად ძალიან მაღალი ხარისხი განათლების მიწოდება სტუდენტებისთვის, მაგრამ ასევე არის თამაში, რაც გვაძლევს იმ საშუალებას, რომ მოვიზიდოთ სტუდენტები და ამ სტუდენტებს მუდმივად უნდოდეთ დაბრუნება სიმულატორთან და თამაშის გაგრძელება. ეს ინოვაციურია გლობალური მარკეტისთვის, იმიტომ რომ არ არსებობს ასეთი ტიპის პროდუქტი არც ერთი. არსებობს მარტო სიმულატორები, რომელიც ძალიან ძვირია, არსებობს მარტო თამაშები, რომელთაც ხარისხი ქირურგიული აბსოლუტურად არ გააჩნია. და კომბინაცია ამ ყველაფრის ერთად არსებობს ჩვენ ქმნით ძალიან მაღალი ხარისხის განათლების მიღების საშუალებას, რომელიც თან არის გასართობი.
მე ვფიქრობ, რომ მენეჯმენტის კუთხით ყოველდღიური ოპერაციების კუთხით აბსოლუტურად განხორციელებადი პროექტია და დიდი, ასე ვთქვათ, პოტენციალის მქონე პროექტია. შესაბამისად, იდეის დონეზე როცა გავიგე სტუდენტები, ოპერაციულ დონეზეც განვიხილეთ და იმიტომ ვართ ერთად დღეს.
Good afternoon, welcome.
Thank you, thank you. That's the switch probably, right?
Yes.
Okay, so good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Vame Kherkheulidze, and I'm the medical doctor and the educator from Georgia. And I have assembled a great team to tackle one of the problems in the world, to change the education world. And as long as the education is pretty boring and very tiresome nowadays, we're going to change it to very exciting and very entertaining and extremely addictive. So we present you our first product, which is the OR, which is the surgical operating room simulation game. It's the simulation, so its main goal is to educate, but it's also a game which makes it pretty entertaining and very addictive. So like everybody wants to come back and play and play and educate themselves. So the team, I'm the CEO of the company, and I have the 3 years of experience in medical education. The CFO has more than 14 years of experience in banking, the finance, and the risk assessment. And the COO has more than 14 years of experience in private and public sector management, and currently specializes mainly in the education management. Now, why did we decide to create the game? Because people crave it. They really want it. And the medical students and even the graduates have absolutely no idea how to perform even the simplest surgeries. And the medical universities don't possess any appropriate tools to teach or to conduct examinations in surgery. So we have talked with 3 universities already, with 2 clinics, 4 leading surgeons in their fields, and more than 100 students, and all of them are extremely excited about the news. And the surgeons agreed to help us in creating the amazing game. And we also did the customer survey, as you see, and the 81% of customers agrees to buy the game right away. The 2% say that they would like to test first, but probably if it's worth it, they're going to buy. And the 17% say that they won't buy, but majority of that 17% are not the medical students. So how are we going to create the game amazing as that? We have a pretty good developer team, actually a great developer team, which have the combined experience of 50 years, and they have produced several very successful games in Georgia already. And our designer currently works with Disney for production of the concept art of one of the upcoming Disney movies. Obviously, we have the competition. But there are 2 types of competitors we have. There are very low level, not surgically or anatomically precise apps, which are just for entertaining, and that's it. There obviously are professional educating centers, and there's the LabSim, for example, which is great for education, but it's not entertaining at all. So we're taking those 2 great things and unite them, so we're establishing a clear connection between education and entertainment. So, and also, we implement the VR, virtual reality headwear, and the interactive glove, which is amazing. I'm going to talk about it in a moment. So what does the customer experience? the customer gets the VR headset on and the interactive gloves on. The CCO of the InGlove just spoke to you several hours ago, and we're implementing the InGlove in our system, in our game. InGlove makes it possible to touch everything in the VR and actually feel everything you touch, the shape and the temperature and so on. And we're also implementing the voice recognition module, so the player will be able to verbally interact with the people inside the OR. So the level of interactiveness is almost to the reality level. So I stand in the OR, I touch everything, I speak with my employees, I do everything, I just look around, I'm in the operating room. So obviously the people who just won't be able to buy the fancy stuff, yeah, they will still be able to play with the usual keyboard and the mouse. And there are several modes. There's a fun mode, which everybody can enjoy. You can download and play and actually experience how does it feel to be a surgeon, which is a great thing, actually. And there's a pro mode for the students and the medical personnel with the complications and everything. And there's an exam mode for the universities and the clinics. And we're selling the game. We're selling the fun and the pro mode for a very cheap price, as you see, for the students. They will be able to buy the individual surgeries or the different packages. And we also have the subscription model for the med schools and the clinics. And we also sell the additional content, the upgrading, the selling the better OR, better scenes, and the better instruments, and so on. We're raising funds for demo creation right now. After creating the demo, we're going to attract more investors and start the Indiegogo or the Kickstarter campaign. And after raising funds, we're going to create the first package, which will involve 10 surgeries, and we're going to start selling there. And we produce every next package in every 2 months, which involves 5 surgeries. So we just produce every 2 months new surgeries. So we update every 2 months, and we sell more and more every 2 months. Now, in parallel with the creation of the first package, we also distribute the demo to the universities and the students. And so as soon as the first package is created, they are ready and waiting and ready to buy right away. Now, the investment we're asking for is $45,000 for the demo creation for the first bundle. The 10-game bundle will need $300,000, and every next bundle will need $90,000 to $100,000. So we are the next big thing in education. And this is happening now. And this is the best way, the OR is the best way to save time and save money and save lives. So I'm offering you to be the part of the change and make the world a better place. Thank you for your attention. Wow.
Anup, you said something earlier with your free game that I think is a very important thing to keep in mind.
Yes.
As you know better than I, there's a shortage of surgeons all over the world.
There is.
What better way to motivate young children, young people, teenagers, to think about becoming a surgeon than have a game that they can play where they're not taking the risk of doing anything dangerous?
Exactly. That's why we have the fun mode. So everybody can experience the surgery, and maybe somebody just wants to become a surgeon and get to the med school. But the real problem is that in the med school, everybody wants to be a surgeon on the first year. Half of them want to be surgeons on the third year, and 10% or even less want to be surgeons on the last year. Why? Because we have never experienced it. We never get in the real OR because we're afraid of it. I mean, you have to touch a real patient. You have no idea what to do. Of course, you're afraid. And this will give these guys the opportunity to learn first and be confident and get into the OR and actually experience real surgeries.
This is super cool. So I just have two related questions.
Yes.
Who creates the content? Because it's actually pretty complicated to do that.
Yeah.
And what makes it a game? Because you talked about VR and so forth, but what aspect of it is gamified?
Okay. The content is created by me and also my employees who work in the surgery, but we mainly, so I'm creating the preliminary content first, then I go to the real surgeons and make them supervise it. And then we create the game, one surgery, and these surgeons test it. And finally, they tell it that this is exactly how it has to be. And that's how the content is created.
And then how is it a game?
How is the game? I don't have a slide of that. You have the slide in the handouts, but obviously I'm going to talk about it. Why it is a game? Because in real life, surgeons compete.
That's true.
Yeah, so that's what we implement in the real game also. There's a competition. There's a player experience gaining, gaining of levels. More levels you get, better surgeon you become, because actually you start playing as the first year resident, and you start playing as the assistant, and then you become better and better and better. More levels you gain, more things you can upgrade for free, but if you don't have the high level to upgrade everything for free, you can actually buy those.
Then you
but
can become an
intern. You upgrade the equipment, by upgrading the equipment and the stuff, you decrease the chance of, or actually increase the chance of success during a surgery, decrease the complications, and yeah, we definitely want to implement the competing between different people. So statistics. So I made this surgery in 5 minutes, and you have done it in 6. Uh-huh. Now you have to beat me. So you go back home and just try
without
to like do it in 4:55 or 4:59. And another thing we want to do, and actually we're planning to do it definitely, is that, for example, I want to play with you. So I contact you, you're in US, I'm in here, I'm in Georgia. We get into the same OR and work together on one patient. So that's
so
online.
You have a
team. That would be definitely, because the teamwork is one of the major concerns in the OR itself.
I have a question. Yes. I might have missed it. In terms of the market size, I mean, it's clearly an important product, especially if everyone wants their doctors to be experienced.
Yes.
You can't get experience until you get experience.
Yeah.
But I sort of wonder, in any given market, just how big a company you can build. And the second question is, it's kind of related, is it seems to me, I mean, I didn't go to medical school, but my gut feel is like a medical textbook is probably several hundred dollars, $200-$400.
Yes.
It seems
Why
like you're way
cheap?
Underpriced. So if your focus is medical schools and education, why wouldn't you sell this for $500? Because if there's no other way to do it and the value, you can't even do this, and I mean, no one's going to let you be on a real patient, so it seems like it's worth much more.
And are you reselling the glove and the headset and bundling it all together, or is it you're just selling the
content? We don't
sell
the glove and the VR ourselves, because it's not our VR and not our glove. We might get it in the bundle itself, but that money doesn't come to us. It goes to the VR, which is used, and several VRs will be able to be used with the game.
But at this point, you've got to buy what does the glove cost?
The glove, I'm not sure yet, because these guys are still in development,
and
but it will cost $400 to $500.
And then you got the VR, that's another 100 or so.
Yeah.
So they're spending $500 on other people's stuff. And
very little on yours.
And 99 cents on yours.
But
bump yours up. Take a piece of theirs.
You know, I agree.
Right.
Obviously,
right.
I agree, because the price of this intellectual, I don't remember the word, is pretty high. Is very high, and we're selling it for
the
very low amount.
Yeah.
But the aim is to educate.
Yeah.
And you're used to the US market and US students who have a lot of money. Now think about Indian students. They can't wear the clothes and they're freezing in winter because they don't have money. I want to get this game to everybody. Because the main aim is to educate. And this is just one, the first product of ours. We are planning to get more and more, cover the surgery, cover the basic subjects, cover everything in medicine, and then move to other parts of education. So our main goal as a company is to make education entertaining.
Mm-hmm.
And
yeah, but
so it's more.
But if you go out of business on the way, you'll never get there. So I think you ought to raise your prices so you have the money to put into your future products.
Well, what I think he's pointing out is there's price elasticity issue of the Georgian market versus the U.S. market and the global market.
Now, I can't make it more expensive for U.S. guys than for Georgian guys.
Exactly.
Yeah, right. So, but if I make it expensive, then a lot of people just won't be able to afford it, and the whole idea will be lost.
So you want to get traction here first.
We will think about it. Raising the price a bit might be possible, but but not $500.
I guess it's a different business if you're going to sell to med schools and clinics than if you're going to sell to me because I'm curious.
Yeah,
those are two different businesses, so and maybe you should figure out which is more important.
The fund will be much cheaper because you just want to enjoy it and you don't want to pay $500, right? But a medical student wants to study, so he pays more. But the universities pay the most.
Pay the most, right.
But I want for students to have it and study. That's the main goal.
Exactly.
That's why I started creating the game.
Great, great. Okay. Thank you so much.
Сакмат გამოკვლილი ვარ. Რამოდენიმე კითხვა მივიღე ისეთი, რომელზეც პასუხი მზად ქონდა და ყველა საინტერესებს ატო არ ყიდით პროდუქტს უფრო ძვირად ვიდრე ვყიდით. ამაზე პასუხი 21 და იგივე მექნება, იმიტომ რომ მინდა რომ გავახციოთ ყველა სტუდენტზე. Იმის მაგალითად და გავყიდოთ ძვირად და გავიდე 100 სტუდენტზე, იმიტომ რომ ჩემი მიზანი არის განათლება და არა ძირითადი მიზანი არ არის შემოსავლის მიღება, არის განათლება, რომლითაც თან შემოსავალს ვიღებ.
Мне говорят, ძალიან კარგად ჩაიარა ყველაფერი. Имеди გვაქვს, რომ შედეგს მივიღებთ.